Okay, good morning friends. So in last class we have discussed briefly about the DC winding. DC armature winding. And we have mentioned many types of classes are types of DC armature winding. Few of them I discuss are single layer winding and two layer winding, which I have discussed already. And then I have discussed about the pole pitch, which can be actually measured in terms of angle, which is 180 electrical degrees. Okay, or it can be measured in terms of number of slots per pole. Number of slots per pole. Again, which can also be converted back to degrees. That is slot angle into number of slots per pole, number of slots per pole, so which is again comes to 180 degrees. And this 180 degrees, this is pole pitch. Okay, so from here onwards we have discussed why we call full pitch coil and fractional pitch coil or fractional pitch winding. Okay, so full pitch windings are called when the coil is, this is coil span is equals to 180 degrees electrical. And fractional pitch is if the coil span is less than 180 degrees is called fractional pitch DC armature winding. Then before that actually we have discussed about the electrical angle and mechanical angle. This is what we have derived the relation between the electrical and mechanical angle. Now and then we have moved to, okay, now let us discuss about the commutator pitch. Okay, so we have coils like this. We have coils like this. This is multi-turn coil. Now these coils are connected to the commutator. This is a commutator. And these are all the segments. Okay, now if suppose this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, these are all commutator segments like this. Now if this winding is connected between segment 1 and suppose say segment 7. If it is connected, this coil is connected between segment 1, commutator segment 1 and segment 7. Then the commutator, yeah, no, I have permitted everyone, there is no request for admission for me. Okay, already 67 participants, students are there. Okay, so then the commutator pitch is equals to 7 minus 1. Is 6. So commutator pitch is this segment minus this segment number. Okay, the end connection minus the starting connection of the commutator segment of a coil. So that is called the commutator pitch. Okay, so in some cases windings or coils may be connected. May be connected to okay. Connected to side by side commutator segments. Okay, this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So starting coil side is connected to first segment. Next coil segment, the end of the coil is connected to the next segment 2, right? So in this case, the commutator pitch is just 2 minus 1 is 1. Okay, so normally the commutator pitch is denoted by C. Normally commutator pitch is denoted by YC. Okay, so knowing these basic terminology about the winding, let me now go to the lap winding. I also said integral slot and fractional slot. Let me also give that brief introduction to that. Integral slot, this is one classification. Integral slot or fractional slot DC armature winding. Here integral slot means if number of slots, total number of slots on armature is exactly divisible by number of poles is integer. Did you follow this? So total number of slots on the armature divided by number of poles is integer, then that type of winding is called the integral slot winding. For example, if I have a 4 pole DC machine with 16 slots on armature, 16 divided by 4 is equal to 4 slots will be coming under each pole. Okay, this is, in this case, the winding wound on this machine will be an integral slot winding. Again, it can be a lap winding or it can be a wave winding or progressive, retrogressive, whatever it may be, but that type of armature is integral slot armature. Now, in some cases, what happens, the fraction is not exactly the integer value. If this value is not integer, but some fraction, then for example, I can say 4-pole machine with 18 slots, 4-pole with or 25 slots. Four pole with 25 slots on armature. Okay, so 25 divided by 4, so it comes to 6 1/4. 6 1/4. Now this is called a fractional slot armature. So under each pole, you are having 6 1/4 slots. Okay, so winding cannot be placed the fraction slots may be dividing under each pole 6 1/4, but winding cannot be done in a fractional manner. So winding can be either 6 or 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So winding can be, I can place the coil side here like this. Or otherwise, I can place in 7. Either this or this. Then in this case, we have in case of fractional slot winding, in case of fractional slot armature, we always have fractional pitch armature winding, because my pole pitch is 6 1/4 is equal to 180 degrees, but I am placing my coil span, this is the coil span, is equal to 6 slots here. 6 slots means, so here if you divide the slot pitch, if you have a slot pitch, this is 180 divided by 6 1/4, so in this case, then I place my coil span from first slot to 6th slot, then my coil span is in degrees. Okay, and in this case, when I place the coil span between 1 and 7th slot, my coil span will be 7 into x degrees, so which is in both cases which is not equals to 180 degrees. Here also it is not equals to 180 degrees. So in both cases, when I have a fractional slot armature, I always have fractional pitch winding, but in case of integral slot, I can choose full pitch winding. I can choose full pitch winding with coil span goes 180 degrees. I can have fractional pitch, which is 180 degrees. Okay.